Hi guys, welcome to another range test video. This is the Audi Q4 Sportback 40 e-tron. In this video, I want to find out the range in real life driving conditions. I will test the range on the highway to find out the minimum range. Then I will also do a second range test in the city at lower average speeds to know the maximum range. I also wanted to know how long it takes to charge the battery at a fast charger. The Audi Q4 Sportback 40 e-tron is a full electric car with a WLTP range of 534 kilometers. It has a lithium battery with a net capacity of 76.6 kilowatt hours, also referred to as 77 kilowatt hours. It is rear-wheel drive and has a power of 204 horsepower. I will first test the range on the highway. There is also a little bit of sporty driving on country roads in this test. The goal of this part of the test is to find out the minimum range of this car by testing it at higher average speeds. At the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 90%. I did the test in December and it was between 9 and 12 degrees. The first part of the test is a drive of 101 kilometers purely on the highway, driving at 120 kilometers per hour. The battery is down to 60% and average consumption is 22 kilowatt hours. I will base my estimated range on the consumption and the net capacity of the battery. The total range based on this consumption is 348 kilometers. I will now leave the highway for some sporty driving on country roads. This part was 26 kilometers and average consumption is with 21.2 kilowatt hours, a bit lower than on the highway. After this part, the total average consumption is 21.9 kilowatt hours. The range increased now to 350 kilometers. Now we will drive all the way back using the highway. Let's have a look at the final result. The battery is down to 23% and the total length of the drive was 231 kilometers. Average consumption was 20.8, so the total range on the highway is 368 kilometers. For the record, I emptied the battery after this part of the test, further down to 13%, with a mix between highway and city driving and with a change in temperature, and I still stayed at a consumption of 20.8 kilowatt hours. Later in this video, I will test the range at lower average speeds. But let's first recharge the car. The Audi Q4 Sportback 40 e-tron is equipped with CCS, combined charging system. This system enables the Q4 Sportback e-tron to be charged with AC and DC. For this test, I will charge the car at a DC fast charger. The Q4 Sportback 40 e-tron can fast charge at a speed of up to 125 kilowatt. Audi says in ideal conditions, the Q4 40 e-tron can recharge enough electricity to cover about 130 kilometers in around 10 minutes. It takes 38 minutes to charge the battery from 5% to 80%. At the beginning of this test, the battery is at 13% and it's 5 degrees outside. The car indicated that it would take around 1 hour and 10 minutes to fully charge the battery. I will do a 30-minute charging test. After 10 minutes, we were cruising at around 103 kilowatt charging speed. The battery increased to 33% and we gained about 88 kilometers on the range indicator. After 30 minutes, the battery is at 72%. The range indicator is at 300 kilometers, so we gained 239 kilometers. I didn't do an AC charging test with the Sportback model. However, in the summer, I did an AC charging test with the regular Q4 40 e-tron. I will share some information about my test results at the end of this video. Let's now test the range at lower average speeds in the city. I want to find out what the maximum range of this car could be. Let's have a look at my results. I did this test the day after the highway test. This day it was a lot colder. The temperature during this part of the test was between 5.5 and 8 degrees. It was also misty. At the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 66%. So the first part of 20 km was purely city driving in Brussels, which is a big city. The battery is at 60% and the average consumption was 20.9 kilowatt hours, which is quite high. The range based on this consumption is 367 km. This is mainly due to the many traffic lights and busier traffic, which results in a lot of stop and go driving. After that, I was still in an urban area, but with more opportunity for continuous driving. I emptied the battery down to 35%. As you can see, consumption dropped a lot, and over a drive of 124 kilometers, my final consumption was 17.4 kilowatt hours. This results in a range of 440 kilometers in the city. In conclusion, I can say that the range of the Audi Q4 Sportback 40 e-tron lies somewhere between 368 and 440 km based on similar driving conditions and measured at rather colder temperatures between 5.5 and 12 degrees. With much colder temperatures, it will probably be less. In the summer, you will probably get more range. Speaking of summer, I did a comparable test with the Q4 40 e-tron. There are some differences between the regular Q4 and the Sportback e-tron. The Q4 e-tron achieves a drag coefficient of 0.28 and the Sportback gets to an even lower figure with a drag coefficient of 0.26. The Sportback weighs a tiny bit more, 2045 kilo versus 2020 kilo in the regular 40 e-tron. The WLTP range for the regular 40 e-tron is 521 kilometer. So in comparison, you should get slightly better results with the Sportback. Let's have a look at some results. The range that I got in the city was 487 kilometer and on the highway I got 399 kilometer. The temperature was between 15 and 20 degrees. I also did an AC charging test with the Q4 40 e-tron. I charged the car at a public charger. The AC public charger had a power of 22 kilowatt, but the onboard charger of the Q4 has a power of 11 kilowatt, so this is what we got. In reality, it took me 6 hours and 25 minutes to fully charge the battery from 15% to 100%. All in all, I think this car performed very well in the range test. It's normal that you get less range in colder temperatures and to get to a range of 368 km to 440 km in these colder temperatures is totally usable for everyday driving. I hope I was able to answer some questions you might have about this car. If you want to know more, I will publish my full review with this car soon. Subscribe if you want to be notified about these future videos.